Hey everyone, Dave here. I've not seen one online, so I thought I'd just do like a super quick review overview of this Milwaukee Crimper. This thing is really, really handy. I'll give you a quick little demo, a little look at it. We've had this one for about 3 years now. This is a company tool, it's not my personal tool. They are quite expensive. It's got the one key, you know, keep track of all your gear. It does up to 400 mil square cables. 400, all right, so, and then does all sizes, so 3, 240, this is going to test me, 180, 150, 120, 95, 70, 50, 35, 25, 16, I'm pretty sure that's right, so it does everything. So you do need to get a hydraulic one to do 600 mil copper. It does alloy and copper, sorry, but yeah, if you need to go up 600, you need something a little bigger anyway. Just you start running out of space in the drawer here, so I'll just pop a battery in and quickly show you how everything works. Rightio, so I've just got a little battery on there. Contrary to popular belief, this does not need a high output battery. This little 3 has done the job for me for many, many crimps. I've just applied a little bit of, you know, I gave it a little clean up in the shed here, the compress there, and I just gave it a little bit of tool oil, because these little indent pins, they what hold the crimping dies in. So we'll go this one. So this is the 95. So basically how to insert the thing, might be a little tricky one-handed, but if you pop it in and press the button so it can set past the middle point. And that's locked in there now. Same on this side. Set it in, press the button, and it'll fall into place. And now they're locked into place. All right, nice and easy peasy. All right, so then you've just got a go trigger and a release trigger. So slow and steady. All right, and obviously when you get, of course, my compressor would kick in. Right, and then you get a little green light here. Hang on, fucking pauses. Sorry after the rude interruption. Right, so obviously we've got and then release. So you don't have to, you can pump it all the way down. You know, if you're doing your crimp here, once you've gone down all the way, you check the little green light, little green LED lights up, and you can release just enough to you know, get your second crimp on if you're going for two crimps, and boom, off you go. So this crimping head has like a full 180 degrees of motion. So if you want to get in like on this side or that side, you know, whatever the access is, yeah, it's pretty good. So this it does every size down to 16. It doesn't do 10 or 6 for some reason. Maybe you can buy those dies, I'm not actually 100% sure. If I've got this on the van, I will not bother using the blue crimpers. The blue crimpers there, the old hand style crimpy ones. Obviously, again, you only need like a hydraulic, you know, the pumpy set for like a 600 mil cable, which, to be honest, we don't do too much anymore. If we're doing big sets, we will go just like sets of flex 400, so this thing keeps us covered. So yeah, it's an excellent tool. If you can justify it, I think it is worth about $5,000 Australian with the dies. If you can justify it and you're going to be using it enough, I would definitely recommend it. Obviously it's a huge purchase to make the jump on. But once you've got it, I mean, this thing's paid for itself easily, in my opinion. Like, just having it on the van, you know, like the hospital job that I'm on at the moment, all the terminations that we've done have been done with this. It makes it a one-man job. Like, you know, if you're lugging and you've got the blue crimper, you sort of need two people doing it. But with this, you can hold the cable, you can hold the lug. All you got to do is pull the trigger with the lug in position and everything works. So yeah, it's an excellent tool. The price is obviously there, but you know, it's, the brand is irrelevant as well in this case. Like it just gets the job done. So just because it happens to be Milwaukee, you know, just makes it a little better. Hashtag Big Matt. Yeah, the Big Matt. All right, so thanks for watching, guys. Cheers. See my war wound. A little Sparky pro tip for you. You want to mark your lugs. You've formed your cable for the bar here. You want to mark your lugs so that lug is going to be straight with where you wanted it on the cable. So I had to trim that copper a little bit just so it's nice and snug on there. But you definitely need to mark it just to make sure that you don't need to fucking twist the shit out of these once it's all crimped on. It can weaken the cable. So Sparky pro tip. Hit me again, big boy. That's good. Little gap into between. Perfect.